Good morning. The net power delivered to an object is described by the equation net power equals 4.00 times time squared plus time in watts. Bobby, please determine the net work done on the object from 0 to 4.00 seconds.
Flippin' physics.
Okay, well, we know the equation for net power, and we are looking for the net work done on the object from 0 to 4.00 seconds. We have a couple of equations for work. The general equation is work equals the integral with respect to x position from x position initial to x position final of force in the x direction. The equation for work done by a constant force equals the dot product of force and displacement, or force times displacement times cosine theta. But I do not see how any of those help us because the net power equation is with respect to time, not position.
Actually, we know power equals the derivative of work with respect to time.
And power equals the dot product of force and velocity, or force times velocity times cosine theta.
Yeah?
Remember, any derivative can be rearranged to form an integral because class. Another term for an integral is an...
antiderivative. Right. We did this before. Starting with power equals the derivative of energy with respect to time, because power can be defined more generally using energy transfer rather than work, multiply both sides by dt, then take the integral of both sides. The left-hand side is with respect to energy, so the limits are from energy initial to energy final. The right-hand side is with respect to time, so the limits are from time initial to time final. The integral of just dE is just energy with the same limits. That equals energy final minus energy initial, or change in energy. And work, by definition, causes a change in energy, so we can replace change in energy with work, and we get work equals the integral from time initial to time final of power with respect to time.
And now we can plug in everything we know. We get the net work from 0 to 4 seconds equals the integral from 0 to 4 seconds of the quantity 4 times time squared plus time, all with respect to time. That integral equals, well, 2 plus 1 is 3, so 4 times time cubed divided by 3 plus 1 plus 1 is 2, so time squared over 2.
Do not forget the limits.
Right, from 0 to 4 seconds. Now we can substitute in numbers for our limits.
Actually, Billy, I'd like to substitute in the variables for time final and time initial into our equation. I'd like to have it written down this way one more time because this is still pretty new for some of you. After this lesson, I am fine with you not showing this particular step. Billy, please keep going.
Now we can substitute in numbers for our limits. We get 4 times 4 cubed all over 3 plus 4 squared all over 2 minus, well, we substitute 0 in for each time initial, so minus 0, and that equals
280 over 3.
Actually, Bo, in physics we do not usually leave our answers in fractions because we need to show the correct number of sig figs.
Sure. Then it is 93.3 repeating, or 93.3 with 3 sig figs.
And what are the units?
Watts.
Joules.
Oh, right. Sorry. Joules. We started with power, so I got a little befuddled.
Befuddled?
Yeah, befuddled. You got beef with that?
No, I do not have any beef with befuddled, though it does leave me a skosh bewildered and perhaps even perplexed.
And lastly, because net work equals change in kinetic energy, we know that change in kinetic energy from 0 to 4 seconds of the object equals positive 93.3 joules. In other words, because the net work done on the object is positive, the net work done on the object is causing a positive change in the kinetic energy of the object. It is increasing the speed of the object.
Cool.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.